She is the relationships editor at Essence Magazine, where she pens a monthly dating advice column. So some of you know her already off of me just saying that. She's also the woman behind the award-winning blog A Belle in Brooklyn, where she talks all about dating and pop culture. And now you can catch all her hilarious dating advice in her book, A Belle in Brooklyn, in which she gives fun and practical advice. Demetria Lucas in the studio with us.
Hey, how are you?
Hi, Ladybug.
How are you? I'm happy to be here.
We're happy to have you because, boy, are you a wealth of information. Yeah, I live vicariously through your book.
Oh, good. Good, good, good.
Because now I'm off the market. But even when I was on the market, I didn't have much fun.
No, you've been in a relationship for a while. You were in a good place. You were in a really good place.
Yeah, it took a long time to get there, I'll be honest with you. But, you know, in your book, and I love this, you ask the question, do black women know how to date?
Mm-hmm.
And I say no, because I certainly didn't.
I say no.
And then you say, we need to learn how to date properly and have fun dating. Talk about that.
Well, I think people forget what dating is supposed to be. It's not supposed to be, you know, auditioning for a husband. It's really to go out and get to know someone and have a good time. And I think people are so focused sometimes on, well, could he be my husband? And is this the one? And, you know, what if my last or his last name and my name? And you just get so far ahead. And it's like, you don't even know, like, the basics about him. You don't know anything about his character. You might not even know where he lives, what he enjoys, what his hobbies are. Like, you know nothing about him. But then you start thinking, like, could this be my husband? You don't even know if you can talk to him, have a conversation. So I say focus on having fun. Focus on doing dating like it's supposed to be done, which is a process of getting to know someone.
And so every time you go on a date, he doesn't have to be your boyfriend. He doesn't have to be your future husband. He could potentially be a good match for your girlfriend.
He could potentially be a good match for your girlfriend. And people freak out when I say that. They're like, oh my God, I would never want to date someone that my friend went out with. If she slept with him, yeah, I kind of get the hesitation there. Like, I totally get that. But because they went out, they had some dinner, they saw a comedy show, they did something, like, you guys can totally be like, no, this is not a good fit for me, but I know who you would be great for. And there are a lot of people that end up married off that.
So we have to learn that.
We did.
Why can't we? I couldn't. I'll be honest with you. I'm a serial monogamist like Jennifer Lopez. Hop from long-ass relationship to long-ass relationship.
I think that's what people have always told us, you know, especially women of color. We're supposed to date. We're supposed to find a husband. Good men are hard to come by. So if you find one, you've got to lock them down. And I get it. I get where our mothers and our aunts were giving us this great advice. They thought it was coming from a good place, but it was also making us crazy. Like, we're all thinking, like, oh, we're never going to meet someone, so we do meet someone. We've got to latch on to that person. Or if he even seems like a good someone, we have to latch on to them. And it makes us a little
crazy.
Little needy, a little crazy.
And then the guys sense that, and they sense desperation. They run for the border.
They run, or they take advantage of it. They exploit it. And that's what you find in a lot of situations is, well, the guy likes to play in the gray area. Like, you're not my girlfriend, but maybe I see it someday. And if you do all this stuff and jump through all these hoops and basically do everything that a girlfriend would, then I'll think about putting a title on it. And then when the woman finally goes push to shove and says, hey, I've been doing all this stuff, he's like, eh. He exploited your neediness. That's exactly what he did.
She's the author of A Belle in Brooklyn. It's Demetria Lucas.